Welcome to Pharmacology Insights, where we break down complex pharmacology into simple, easy-to-understand concepts. In August 2025, Brensocatib, under the brand name Brinsupri, became not only the first therapy specifically approved for non-cystic fibrosis bronchiectasis, but also the first dipeptidyl peptidase 1 inhibitor approved for any neutrophil-mediated disease. In this video, we'll take a look at how it works at the molecular level and the clinical evidence that led to its approval. Let's get started. Non-cystic fibrosis bronchiectasis, or NFCB, is a condition where the airways become permanently widened. This leads to mucus buildup, chronic infections, and persistent inflammation. Patients often struggle with frequent pulmonary exacerbations, involving episodes of cough, thick sputum, shortness of breath, and repeated respiratory infections. A key player in this disease is the neutrophil, a type of white blood cell. Normally, neutrophils fight infection by releasing powerful enzymes called neutrophil serine proteases, including neutrophil elastase, proteinase 3, and cathepsin G. When first made, these proteases are inactive, like factory-made gadgets still sealed in their packaging. To unbox them, the maturing neutrophil relies on a special enzyme called dipeptidyl peptidase 1, or DPP-1. Think of DPP-1 as the activation scissors. It clips tiny fragments off the inactive proteases, converting them into active enzymes. This happens inside neutrophil precursors in the bone marrow, while their granules are being formed. By the time neutrophils enter the bloodstream, their granules are already stocked with active proteases, ready to be deployed when the cell reaches an infection site. When neutrophils reach the inflamed lungs, they release these proteases to kill microbes. In non-cystic fibrosis bronchiectasis, neutrophils become overactive and release far too many proteases. Instead of only fighting germs, the excess proteases chew through healthy lung tissue, worsening inflammation and fueling disease progression. It's like firefighters trying to save a burning building, but spraying acid instead of water. This is where Brensocatib steps in. It is an oral, reversible DPP-1 inhibitor. By blocking DPP-1, Brensocatib prevents the activation of neutrophil elastase, cathepsin G, and proteinase 3. That means neutrophils are still made and can still fight infection, but they're less destructive because their most damaging weapons, the proteases, stay inactive. In other words, Brensocatib tones down the collateral damage caused by neutrophils, reducing airway inflammation and protecting lung tissue. The FDA approval of Brensocatib was supported by the ASPEN trial, the largest bronchiectasis clinical study ever conducted to date, with over 1,700 participants. Here's what the trial found. Patients on Brensocatib had fewer pulmonary exacerbations than those on placebo. Both the 10 mg and 25 mg doses cut exacerbation rates by about 20% compared with placebo. Brensocatib also delayed the time to the first exacerbation, meaning patients stayed well for longer. Encouragingly, more patients stayed exacerbation-free. At 1 year, nearly half of patients on Brensocatib had no flare-ups, compared with only 40% on placebo. Additionally, the decline in lung function, measured by FEV1, was slower in the Brensocatib groups. The 25 mg dose in particular preserved lung function better than placebo. The benefits were seen across different groups, including adolescents, patients already on macrolides, and patients with both high and low eosinophil counts. In short, Brensocatib not only reduces the frequency of flare-ups, but also maintained lung function, two critical goals in NFCB. For decades, bronchiectasis treatment focused mainly on managing symptoms, like mucus clearance, antibiotics, and airway therapy. Brensocatib is the first treatment to directly target neutrophil-driven inflammation, shifting the approach from symptom control to disease modification. Experts are calling this a landmark in respiratory medicine. So, to sum it up, Brensocatib works by blocking DPP-1, keeping neutrophil serine proteases inactive. That means neutrophils stay functional but less destructive, reducing inflammation and protecting lung tissue. Backed by the ASPEN trial, brensocatib is now the first approved therapy for non-cystic fibrosis bronchiectasis, offering new hope for thousands of patients who previously had no targeted treatment. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.